Now, the Australian perspective is bound to differ from time to time with the perspective of the United States. And of course, on occasions, friends do disagree, as we did on this side with you on the war in Iraq. But such is the strength of our shared values, our interests, our principles, that those differences can enrich rather than diminish, they can strengthen rather than weaken the partnership. Our commitment to the alliance remains unshakable, as does our commitment to the war on terror. But friends must be honest with each other. Honesty is, after all, the foundation stone of that great Australian value, mateship.
Men and women of the Kanimbla and their families who are gathered here today, for us to farewell you and to wish you Godspeed and a safe and speedy return. I don't want to mince my words because I don't believe that you should be going. I don't think that there should be a deployment of troops to Iraq ahead of the United Nations determining. But that's a political decision. That's an argument that the Prime Minister and I will have, no doubt, over coming weeks and months. But having said that I don't support the deployment of our troops in these circumstances, I do support our troops and always will. And that distinction is fundamentally important. The men and women of our fighting forces in a democracy are expected, unquestioningly, to accept the orders of the government of the day. You don't have a choice. And my argument is with the government, not with you.